Hello everybody, welcome to the video. And my name is Owen Fox and I'm with my really beautiful, amazing friend Minda. And we're driving in Canada, Park, in Canada. And we just watched a video about the woman saying, I'm vegan but my boyfriend isn't. And she was saying like she's not I love this person too, and she's a friend of mine to a degree. And she said, she's not a judgmental person, she just wants to focus on herself. She wants to choose her own decisions, not trying to force someone to choose their decisions. And my wonderful ex-partner also, she said both of them are highly energy sensitive ladies, and she also feels like she wants to connect with the person and many of their qualities. It's not just totally dependent on their diet. Because as you know, and I know, there's many other facets to a human being and the relationship than simply food. But food, what I want to add in this video is that it's the discussion. It's not me telling you what's right or wrong, but let's all talk about it. For me, food does represent a lot of stuff. And it does play a part in your overall, where you are in life as a human being, what food you eat, or if you even use physical food too, because there's breatharians out there, and there's the juicetarians, there's fruitarians, there's raw foodists, there's cooked food vegans, there's vegetarians. This is the scale, you know. There's people, the breatharians are solitarians, they live on the subtle energy of light, love, emotions. Prana, of course. So in this video I want to ask Minda, what are your thoughts on the video we just saw? Maybe drive slowly. What are your videos, what are your thoughts about veganism and relationships and all that sort of stuff? Because you've got loads to share, I know that, and I want to help you to share. Regarding going out with a non-vegan, if you're a vegan, or the whole diet topic of relationships and having the same diet, what do you think, Minda?
I would think that at least idea those two people should have kind of the same. At least idea. If there is no even idea, I don't think it will be a good match. These people should wait.
Similar ethical or environmental principles?
Yeah.
Or idea, human principles?
Yeah, but then the actions. Will they follow actions, together? Will they take that journey together?
Yeah.
So when your friend,
Avian,
the lady, Avian.
Yeah.
Avian seems like her choices of boyfriends are, whatever. And then she says, I'll lead by example, which is very nice, which is, understandable.
Very good, yeah.
But if the person, if your partner, you're kind of choosing, of course it's a love, blind love. If he has no any intention yet, it's like getting the car, which you don't know, will it kick the first gear ever?
Okay, so you're...
But of course, you still have chance, by example, it's very powerful by example, but I would recommend her to...
Speak the truth, what are you saying? You'd recommend her to get a vegan boyfriend?
I wouldn't recommend now.
Or a vegetarian?
She's in partnership, okay, but maybe a bit of a message to her boyfriend. And maybe it's a help for her at the
After
same time.
300 meters.
It's loads of reasons why it's so important. It's one of the most important causes. Vegan. Unfortunately, it's not raw. I wish it would be raw or vegetarianism or whatever.
Yeah. But you think it's veganism is very crucially important in life?
Yeah.
For the earth?
For many reasons. It's a number one cause for, world hunger. So that means the person who is not
non-veganism, animal exploitation and all that sort of stuff is helping create world hunger. The number one cause.
It's number one cause for world hunger. Number one cause for health-wise, cardiovascular disease. It's number one cause.
Eating animals.
Yeah,
and dairy and butter and yogurt and cheese and
so think about
chicken and fish.
Yeah. Think about what perspective you're creating as a partnership, you know, for long term, including when, you know, possibly will be kids or so on. So will you be able to care for kids properly, like just getting some kind of cardiovascular disease?
Yeah, I agree with this.
It's number one cause for cancer. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I wanted to say, like, I had a really hard conversation with my mother, like, loads of times, like, not very hard, but with the conflict. And basically, he said, "Mom, you're my only parent left. Like, if you're going to be eating like this sort of crappy, shitty food, you're going to die on me young, and you already have some health problems. I can see like you're deteriorating, and have been going down, like health-wise, to a degree, unnatural aging. And like, I'm sad and upset to see you eating badly because I know you're going to die young. And then if I have children, which I'm sure I will, then they're going to lose their grandmother and I'm going to lose my only parent left. And like, actually, my mom is my closest person in my family too, so I'm going to lose a really good friend and the best supporter of my life and my biggest loved one. Like, so like, you can't be selfish eating shitty because, or taking drugs or doing like dangerous behavior like rock climbing with no ropes if you have a family, because you risk dying, and then your loved ones who you're supporting or need you or have a connection with you, they're just going to lose you. And so you have to think about the environment and your loved ones also. It's not just about you, we're connected. So this is why I love Minda. Like, he thinks about the connection, about influencing each other. Like, he's such a caring person, like he cares so much. And he's like, he admits he's not perfect, but he tries to spread information to help people and the world to be better together. Go Minda.
Go
Minda. So Minda's not a judgmental person. He admits to his own failings too, but he also just wants to try and improve himself also, and others at the same time.
So can I continue?
Yeah.
About,
tell us more, Minda.
Just importance, just to realize and maybe think that it's like, let's say at least four types of vegan, understanding of veganism.
Yeah.
Like, and environmental, health-wise, spiritual-wise, and what's the fourth?
Maybe athletic, health, that's health.
You know, health, environment, which is like your external body.
Yeah.
Environment.
And for the animals.
Ethical. Ethics and morality as a human being.
Yeah.
Yeah, so these four would be the main ones. So that means, like, I would recommend to ask a question. Am I a vegan? Have I reached a level of veganism for morality and ethics? Have I reached my level of veganism for environmental reasons? For health reasons? Okay? Some people come up to one side, like, let's say, for morality or ethics. Some people come through the health, you know. But then we need to work a little bit and upgrade for other reasons as well. So we will kind of be stronger in the weakest moments.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so just to continue, like, a few more reasons why it's number one cause.
Yeah, what's the problem of not vegetarianism in the world? Like, all the consummation and production of animals and all that sort of stuff. What causes does it do in the world?
Yeah, like, for example, deforestation. It's number one cause for deforestation. It's number one cause for greenhouse emissions. Most people would think it's like cars. Not all cars, planes, ships altogether. It's about 13%.
13, yeah, one tree. Yeah,
while this animal kind of industry, agriculture, is 51%, according, I forgot, United Nations or World Health Organization.
Yeah, so...
So that's, what is primary cause? So let's concentrate on that at the moment.
And the Amazon and other rainforests are chopped down to grow crops to feed the animals, which the humans then eat. So it's like a massive amount of land, like... crazy amounts of square kilometers every day is being chopped down, something like that, to either grow fuel for the electricity or something for the transportation or production of animals, or for the land, especially to grow crops to feed the animals. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's just stupid and ridiculous, basically, bluntly put. But it's extremely selfish, in my opinion, for the way humans are carrying on. We're acting like babies, wrecking our home because we want to eat food, like meat that we don't even need, that the Illuminati have brainwashed us into thinking we need your calcium and your protein. All these like lies and jokes that we don't need is like from the animals at all.
Well, it's information which is spread and it's just strong enough, and that's a culture. That's why we need to change, like not us change culture, but participate.
Yeah.
Creating like next level of culture. And that's why like, I think partner is kind of important, you know. Will he suppress you, you know?
Or promote and encourage and expand stronger together.
Yeah.
So like, I have no judgment about like anyone who's like has their partner. Like, I don't know, I'm not a relationship expert, but I think I'm better than I used to be, and that's all I can say for sure.
Yeah.
So I don't know. So like, maybe if somebody is in a relationship when they're vegan and they're with somebody who's not vegan, or a breatharian with a vegetarian, or like raw food this with a meat eater or something, I don't know. Different type of levels of like either health promotion or like unhealth promotion to the world. And our functioning ability as a human divine being, like our body vessel functions better on as a cleaner, lighter intake of fuel and substance into our body. So yeah, I don't know, but I'd like to know, do you know, and like what do you think regarding compatibility in relationships? Overall, I'd have to say, I think if you're on the same path, you can become stronger together as a team to make a positive influence in your own life and those around you and the world, generally speaking. But no judgment on anybody.
Yeah.
So anyway, here's a piece of paper about speciesism. Speciesism is like racist to another species. And eating meat, dairy, eggs, and chicken, and fish, and all that sort of stuff, it promotes like world hunger, because the waste of land and other resources for all the animal production. And there's 0.8 of a billion people who are in extreme poverty in the world, with like less than $1.25 per day income, which is crazy. And 30 million deaths a year from hunger. So if we did try and get like, if as a species, if we switched more towards like raw food and vegetarianism and veganism, we'd definitely like increased the health of the world, right?
Absolutely.
And then loads of people die every year from cardiovascular disease because of like eating, clogging their arteries with like all this like meat products and animal products. Cancer massively increased after World War II because of all the chemicals, but also because of everyone started eating meat then, like loads, every day instead of once a week. Deforestation, greenhouse, yeah, Minda already said that. And then, of course, animal distinction and animal like violence and abuse and torture.
Water pollution.
Yeah.
Like number one cause for water pollution.
Yeah.
It's not like, you know, turn off the tap or like... And then, you know, like tiny things, you know, like one burger, 660 liters water wasted. One burger.
And can you explain, Minda, because right now, if I try and think about that, I'm wondering how does that happen? But I'm guessing
it happens just
because
it's another topic. Another video, or it's the best video. Just have a look, Cowspiracy
on YouTube.
If you think you are environmentalist, but still not vegan, it's like... Must have a look into that.
And of course, everyone
can see that statistics and facts.
Yeah.
You know.
We aren't trying to like say we're above anybody. And I generally personally don't even call myself any name like vegan or raw foodist or breatharian. But I can see the advantages and disadvantages of having labels like printed on your t-shirt, for example. Helps spread awareness. On another hand, it can help spread division and like all. So it's positives and negatives, okay? Well, the real thing is like how deeply are you identified with that as who you are, okay? That's what I think about like labels and like, self-labels and attachments and identifications. But like you don't have to be like 100% something and to be having an influence. Like every percent is an influence. Like, so in my life, like I'm sometimes positive and sometimes negative. I'm sometimes happy and sometimes sad. I'm sometimes frustrated and sometimes like in peace.
I'm sometimes eating like brilliantly and sometimes like eating badly, you know. So same with Minda. So the more you can basically do positive, that's good in any area, including this whole topic too. So it's not necessarily about all or it's nothing about all or nothing or be perfect. It's just about doing your part and growing as a human being and improving and being responsible, really. And for me, it's about being responsible and about being open to learning more so I can become more responsible, more conscious. Break?
Not necessarily.
One thing that I forgot to say is, which I was saying to Minda before the video, like the question for me is not about, you're in a relationship with somebody and it's not about not judging them. It's not about like, well, they have freedom to choose too and I'm not a controlling person. For me, the question is not about everyone has free will and everyone can do what they want. But the question is, like, why or who would you choose to get into a relationship with at the beginning? Like, not that we're trying to change them, but we have the choice to get with who we want to get with in life. So, like, would we get with, like in a murderer, like an abuser? Would we get with someone who's, like, super, like, mean? Or would we get with someone who's, like, a little, like, who do we get with in life to be our partner? Like, so
for what reasons? Like, if it's not like a world hunger, it's not environmental, it's not like a spiritual reasons, so for what reason we get into relationships then?
Yeah, so what I'm thinking is, like, if you get into a relationship with someone and, like, let's say you're a raw foodist and they're a meat eater and, like, a heavy energy eater, and maybe it's factory farm polluting, like polluting their body and their psyche and all that stuff, or a hardcore heroin addict or something. We don't want to get with a heroin addict and say, oh, well, we, like, everyone's got free will, I don't want to change anyone. Like, it's just I do my thing, they do their thing. But at the end of the day, like, is it good to be in a relationship with a heroin addict? Is it good to be like a breatharian or like a vegetarian and in a relationship with like a non-vegetarian, or a raw foodist with like something like a not raw foodist thing, but like,
can I add a bit?
Yeah.
Even the thinking about the kids. Imagine, like, even will be like you possibly will split if that person is not shifting in his consciousness. Then, Then imagine you have a kids,
yeah.
And then you need to give a time for the kids with a father or with a mother. Like, I know with a group, you know, like a. Our parents as well, grandmothers.
So the influence
for the kids, what will be, you know?
Yeah. So
at least partner, you know, like it will be problems with your parents when you leave the kids there, you know, maybe sometimes, or you visit those parents.
Yeah, because
so at least partner as a like a supportive you know, like you're not alone in that. Kind of like raising that awareness of this ethics in your family.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying, Minda. I understand what you're saying completely. So I hope you understand what he's saying there. Like, you know, sometimes you have, like, let's say you're on a diet, like vegetarian, let's say, for example, and then your parents babysit and then they start giving your child meat. Do you want that, especially if it's like contaminated factory farms, like toxic rubbish that's like seriously bad for you? So this video, like, we're mostly focusing on like factory farm stuff. It's by far the biggest pollutant. So we know organic, grass-fed, free-range meat is much healthier and like better than the serious hardcore druggy serious factory farm stuff, of course. So what I wanted to say earlier, getting back to the point, is like being careful with who you choose to be with. And for me, like I said earlier, I don't know everything. So, like, maybe, for example, a vegetarian gets with a vegan gets with someone who's not even a vegetarian too, or they eat some meat. That's brilliant. Like, less is better than loads. Like, better for your health, better for the environment and the animals. If you're eating meat once a week or twice a week instead of like two or three times per day, of course. Yeah. So, obviously, what I'm curious about personally is like what connections and bond and like beautiful things are binding you together that are outside of the whole food. This intrigues me as a person, like, who wants to learn, you know. I'm not trying to tell you what to do or that I know everything. I'm asking you, like, what do you know that I might not know? And like, how can I benefit from your story also? But
nice.
As a human being, like, I'm seriously curious about, like, I think what Minda said is very important, and like what I said also. And I'm curious about the whole fact of like choosing very carefully also who you want to be with and the relationship. So for me personally, I just couldn't imagine like going out with someone who eats meat. For me, it's like way too weird and like backwards almost. Like, sorry if it sounds just mental, but it's just like too weird and heavy and dense and too much cruelty and like usage and exploitation. But you know, like if someone wants to say like, you know, where I am, if they're like breatharian or solitarian or something, and they think where I am is like all weird and backward and like heavy, that's cool with me. Like, there's no judgment here. It's just about like description of the energies and the effect of our actions. Like, I know I am, and it's perfect, and I try like my best, and everyone tries their best, and I'm not judging anyone who's trying their best. But I'm wondering, if you're trying your best and someone else isn't trying their best, is that a good compatibility? Like, if you're open to diet and energy improvement and emotional improvement and healing, and someone else isn't as open or isn't open really much, it depends how much they're open and how fast or slow you're moving. If you're both moving at totally different speeds, then that isn't going to facilitate a long-term relationship or expansion together, a powerful expansion couple. Or you won't be seeing eye to eye right now either, if you're both changing too fast in different directions slightly. So... does that make sense, Minda?
Makes sense. Very good. Very good.
So I'm curious, like, because to be honest, a lot of people just like pick their partners like so recklessly, so ridiculously, like, and then just go out with anybody. And the reason is because they're hurt and traumatized and lonely and sad and insecure and unfulfilled and all these other reasons. Like, to be honest, so like I'd prefer. I'm trying myself in my own life to be more like careful. Everyone is trying to be more careful in everything. Well, at least I am. I'm trying to be more careful in everything. So, I think we should test drive relationships, like, and not be attached to, like, test drive for a few weeks or months, like, test drive. It's way more important to test drive your relationship than to test drive your car or your house. And you want to be able to drop it if it's not, like, fully serving both of you to the highest order, in my humble opinion. Leave quick, or leave anytime you want if it's not serving the both of you. What do you think, Minda?
Nothing to add.
Yeah. On another note, Minda, in defense of your driving while eating a melon, is it because we're on a really, really like quiet, like park, national park type of road?
Yeah. It's empty road.
And people will like give out to you for doing this.
You're driving pretty slow because of lots of bumps.
Bumps and no traffic, yeah? All right. Just trying to be transparent to everyone, like. I know some people will be wondering about this, so I'm not trying to hide or pretend or avoid. I'm just trying to face everything.
Maybe a name of video could be, can you drive, is it good to drive while eating melons?
So yeah, me and Minda, like, you know, good sense of humor. Minda's my best friend, like, along with other best friends. Best friends, maybe. Yeah, you know what I mean. So this video is serious, but at the same time, it's good to have lightness in life, you know, not to get bloody crazy about topics. Just try and be open and learn. That's all I'm trying to say. Minda, I think that's more or less what Minda's trying to say. Be open and learn and be willing to improve, yeah?
Or, yeah, learn from other experiences.
Yeah.
And for me, it would be easy to prognose what... Well, I probably had relationships where I split because of... I started shifting. And the partner is not shifting, and that makes it causing problems, you know, up to like really uncomfortable and stressful, and you know. So,
because Minda, from knowing you, I see that you don't like to see bad things happening to animals or humans or to the world, right? And this is what I've seen in you, and you don't like it when someone else doesn't care or give a shit, like. Giving a shit sounds like bad or judgmental, and I'm sorry if that sounded that way, but you don't like when other people care, like, and me too. It kind of hurts your feelings if, like, if you see someone bullying and you say, well, hey, let's stop these from bullying, that's like really bad, and your partner or your friend or other human being is like, whatever, I'm more interested in like other little things in life, and you don't find those things important or like subtle, like the surface level things, I mean, like looks, beauty, fashion, and like, and that. You know what I mean? Society type of things, like McDonald's. And if you're interested in like not being a bully or helping protect someone from being bullied, this is what I see in Minda. He's trying to like help people and protect things, like be good. Like Minda for me is like a very virtuous, like honorable person of high integrity and like high moral, like ethical standards. And he's not perfect, and neither am I, and nobody's perfect. But he tries, and he's open, is what I'm trying to tell you. It's sad if someone else, like who's supposed to be close to you, doesn't care about these things. You know, it's so important to you. And we're all at different stages. Like, I'm not better than anyone. Like, maybe I don't care what someone else really cares about, and they think, "Hey, listen, Owen, you're not caring." And then I'd like to say, "Oh, I'm sorry. Like, let me learn from you." But other people, when they don't want to be open and say, "I'm sorry, let me learn," like if something really good information, then it leads to a disconnection, like our bonds in a friendship or family or an intimate relationship. If you're not on the same like thinking way a little bit, like obviously everyone's different, but yeah.
Yep.
Anything else?
No.
Okay. Do you want to say goodbye?
Yeah, goodbye.
Okay.
Thanks for listening.
Yeah, yeah.
See everyone, lots of love. Thanks for listening, and please leave your comments below, and your, if you feel like it, any of your thoughts, your, like what I want you to do is like put something below that I think I can learn from or benefit from. So if you have a good comment that you think is good for me and Minda, like helpful for the world, to other people to see, just leave something positive and beneficial, like in a respectful way, okay? And please share the video to help raise awareness on this discussion. Because this isn't a telling you what to do video, it's a discussion that everyone can learn together. So please share and like, share with your friends, family and social media, and subscribe and befriend me on Facebook. And you can befriend Minda on Facebook too, like so much good, such a good power, like good connection to have, friend, like such a like good, healthy, positive, like light worker or helper, like on the planet. Honestly, like it's so good, like. So, and I'd like to be the same. If you're doing something really cool, I'd love to support you and like promote you and share with your work with my friends or fans or like followers, you know what I mean? Friendly followers type of people. Like, we're all, I'm a follower too. So, yeah, let's all work together to make the planet better and individual lives better. Yeah. Okay, that's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Pretty good. Thank you.
See
you. Bye. Forgot to say that eating a lot of factory farmed meat or fish or even, I don't know, whatever amount, overall factory farming in the world causes a huge amount of like land, water, river, lake, sea pollution. A massive amount of pollution. Loads of chemicals and pesticides and fertilizers and growth hormones and antibiotics, like drug waste pollution, chemical pollution, poisoning fish, polluting the waterways, sea pollution, ocean. It's just massive amount of like poop pollution as well. Huge poop pollution from like cows and animals too. Loads and loads and loads and loads of waste. That's true, eh, Minda?
True.
It's crazy.
And so that's a partner I would like to be with, you know, who
doesn't care about that, to change,
who is just doing, participating in that, voting his money into that, you know,
and they want to keep doing it after you say it's bad.
Yes, exactly. Or not willing to investigate.
Yeah, not
willing to spend time. That's like, whoa.
Yeah, that's like what we said, like, yeah. Not open, like to positive change. That's what we said earlier, another way, not willing to investigate. Whoa, what am I doing, is so bad. And like I was saying to Minda a second ago, it's like throwing loads of like plastic bags everywhere, like rubbishing the heck out of the place. If you're doing that, I was saying that's like shit behavior. Whether or not you're trying to be a shit behaviorist, it's still shit behavior. Imagine like polluting this beautiful land with like loads of rubbish and like plastic and like throwing everything all around the place. Whether or not you want to admit it, it's still like a really not nice thing to do. So whether or not you know about it, the thing is, if somebody tells you, like, look, you're killing wildlife, I said it'd be even worse if you threw all these like plastic bags all over into the rivers and then you're killing loads of fish. Well, factory farming is even worse than this. Like, you're doing massive like pollution, environmental damage, like killings, like, let alone the animal slaughter. We didn't even talk about animal rights here, or like, do they have a right to live? And like, in my opinion, they do. And like, we should cause as little like harm to other lives as possible. insects do. And I know you can't avoid killing things, like even driving a car, you're killing bugs. Breathing, you're killing microorganisms. But it's about the things you can avoid relatively easily. That's where we have the proper, real choice, eh? Like, doing anything probably might even hurt a human being. Like, having a car in a first world country or having a home could, in a way, you could say, like, wearing clothes that are made in a sweat lodge, possibly. Are we conscious about this? And for me, everything in my life is I want to be more conscious about. I want to cause as least harm and hurt as possible. So I want to change my clothes, be more environmentally friendly, and fair trade, like fair work, like not from child labourer camps, but like just because you can avoid this. So if someone says, oh, well, you're always hurting animals and insects no matter what, so don't even try. That's like, don't even try to be vegetarian or vegan or anything. That's like saying, oh, well, you're somehow causing some hurt or negative effect to another human on the planet, so that doesn't matter if you go around punching other humans in your neighborhood, because you're still causing, you can't avoid causing pain to another human being. Obviously, we can avoid not punching humans, and we can avoid the big growth scale of not causing widespread bad factory farm damage or even animal killing as well, even if it's a small scale. But everyone has a different belief. Some people believe, like, you know, animals don't have a right to life, or it's been proven scientifically beyond a shadow of a doubt. They obviously feel pain. They have a very sophisticated central nervous system. Countless studies have said animals often have, like, the psyche or the intelligence of a 2-year-old to a 5-year-old child. Pigs especially. Elephants, very intelligent. Pigs. Dolphins are the other...
emotionally very developed, way higher than humans.
Dolphins are the other terrestrial life form. Humans and dolphins are the two advanced human species on Earth. They're not below us at all. In terms of sophistication, extremely sophisticated, just a different way. So, yeah, I guess the point is what I just said, really. So the more you care, the more you'd be willing to investigate in life about these serious topics, less your the amount of distractions in life, like such as stress and other things distracting you from your ability to investigate. So how much have you been investigating about this sort of stuff and willing to be open and listen and investigate and learn? You know, so there's different factors of why we don't, like such as distractions and stress and all that sort of stuff, suffering and problems in life. But it's good to bear that in mind. It's good to be open, to be willing to investigate and learn.